Hello, Power Query fans. In this video, I'm going to show you how to apply the function to reference the previous rows in Power Query, because it's a bit counterintuitive. So in my blog post here, I scroll down and check the first simple function. I go to view raw, and this gets me to the GitHub page with the code easily to be copied. And then I'm going to open Power BI Desktop, get data, and create an blank query here. Then I go to the advanced editor, Control A, check everything, and Control V, paste the copied function code, like so. So this gives me the function dialog. And because the function is the only query in my model and I don't have a table yet, this dialog field where I could select a table is actually grayed out. But we can change this and create a table quickly. Now I have a simple table here, and when I go back to my function, I see that I can actually select a table. And if I do that, I have to enter my column name. I believe that has been column 1, and I invoke the function. And then you see that I get a new query here from the invoked function, where I have my original table, which just had one column here, 1, 2, 4, and the previous row, exactly what I wanted, gets the previous row in an additional column here. But often, this is not what you want, actually. Often one wants the additional column with the previous row in the original table. So I want to find a way how to apply this function. Let's call it previous row simple. I want to call this function in my existing table. And there, the crucial step is not to invoke a custom function like you might be used to with this command here, but instead you click on this add step symbol here. And from here, you reference the function, which is function previous row simple. And the first argument is my table, so I keep the reference to the previous step. And the second argument is my column name, which is column 1. And close the parentheses. And now you see I have my additional column with the previous row in the exact same table where I started. So the trick here is to create an additional step which contains the function parameters.